Hi, in this session we are going to understand what is an algorithm. An algorithm is nothing but set of instructions for solving a given problem. As the definition says, this is a step-by-step unambiguous instructions for solving a problem. See, the word unambiguous means, if you follow these instructions, there should not be any ambiguity in getting the solution. Okay, for a given problem, if we have set of instructions for solving that, how do we know whether the given algorithm is correct or not? How do we know whether the given algorithm is good or not? That we decide based upon these two properties. One is correctness and the other one is efficiency. Correctness means, if we follow these instructions, if we follow the given instructions, are we getting the solution or not? Efficiency means, how much computer resources, like CPU, memory, are being consumed for this solution, for this algorithm. So if we say the algorithm is good, if it is correct, as well as if it is efficient. Just to see some examples of the algorithms, let us consider preparing an omelette. You can see that these are the instructions for preparing the omelette. Okay, first we are getting the frying pan, then we are getting the oil, then we turn on the stove. Like that we keep going. So if you carefully observe, the second step has the sub-steps. First we are checking, do we have oil or not? If not, whether we want to purchase it or not. If we decide not to purchase, we can terminate there itself. If yes, we can buy the oil and then go to the third step. So these are the instructions for solving this problem, preparing an omelette. And we can also see that these are the descriptive instructions for solving this problem. Now let us go on to the other example where we have defined in terms of function. Given an array of n elements, how do you find the maximum element? You all know, right? We can simply iterate through all the elements and use some simple variable, keep updating it if the current value is greater than the max element. Let us consider this one. So we are doing some initialization. Assume that this is the max variable. And at the end of the function, this will have the max element in the given array, which is initialized with integer minimum. That means, among the integer values, whatever is the minimum, it is defined in C and C++. Similarly, you can assume for other languages as well. And once the initialization is done, we are going through all the elements of the given array from 0 to n. And if the current value of the array is greater than the max element, we are updating the max element with the current value. And then we can do the same thing for all the elements of the given array. And at the ending, we are returning whatever is there in the max variable. So forget about actually how we are implementing this finding the max element. But these are the instructions for solving this problem. There could be multiple ways of solving the same problem. Assume that this is one solution. Okay, that means for a given function f of n, how can we write this set of instructions? Here we are doing some initialization which is going to take some constant amount of time. Let us say 1. The second instruction is nothing but that is also an initialization. That also takes order of 1. Then we are iterating through all the elements of the given array which is nothing but size of m. We don't know values of m. It can be varying. Okay? So since we are iterating through all the elements of the given array, assume that we are taking some n times or whatever. Same thing can be represented as 2 plus n. So if you carefully observe, for solving the problem is finding the max element in the given array. We have iterated the code and same thing we have represented in terms of function like this. Suppose if we have two nested for loops, it will be n square or something like that. Similarly, you can assume for the other functions and other algorithms. What I indirectly saying is, the solution, the instructions for the given problem can be represented as a set of descriptive instructions. We can define in terms of function. We can define in terms of code like this. So here there are three variants. One is descriptive instructions. We have defined in terms of function. We have defined in terms of code with any programming language. Let us see another example where we can convert the function to a code. For example, we all know, right, factorial of n is equal to n into factorial of n minus 1. Just a simple example. Is equal to 1 if n is equal to 1. So we can simply write the simple code for this one. N if n is equal to 1, return 1. Else return n into
That's the families.
Here, the important thing that we need to understand is the instructions for solving the given problem. We can represent in terms of functions, we can represent in terms of code, or we can represent in terms of descriptive statements.